is a practical science. It attempts to simulate real life situations and also decision making, problem solving with uncertainty.
We are number one in terms of research publications in the area of management. We have about 70 books published by the department faculty, which numbers only about 14. We have got these books published by best of the publishers.
But when we look at executive success, we find the people who succeed are those who are able to manage with less information, who are able to integrate social sciences and the physical sciences, who are able to integrate technology with people, and who are able to manage emotions, feelings, if I may say, while on the run.
It was almost after 6 months that I entered the gates of DMS that I was asked to sum up all the facets of management education. Under the guidance of some of the best professors, the endless discussions in the clubs, and the long hours spent discussing various topics in the dorm rooms. All of these learnings come together in that one term paper at DMS.
The term paper is a unique concept where we bring in all our semester's learnings in various forms, like club discussions, market research, surveys, theories learned in the classroom, and various other discussions. We churn everything, every kind of theory, into a 30-minute paper presentation.
I think the days of knowledge imparting are over. That job is probably done better by Google or Wikipedia than the classroom teaching. We attempt to look at making practical theorists.
And students, our students are also very little different. Majority of them have some work experience. So when we try to correlate our own experiences with the industry world, now they immediately get connected. And they understand that there is the theory and the practicing world have a lot of similarity, and we try to put them in different situations during our class discussion. We try to give them different scenarios, and we expect the student to respond back in terms of the strategies, in terms of the operating principles, and how they will respond to these different scenarios.
Theory is great, but it kind of never works in real life in perfection.
Professors in DMS don't just refer to textbooks. They go to the very depth of the subject by referring to unique papers that are out there in the best of the journals of the world.
In fact, our belief is that you learn management more outside the classroom than inside the classroom. You learn management by cross-learning, cross-discussions. You learn management in the hostels. You learn management through simulation and games. You learn management through case studies.
Ours is a small batch, and when we have a case study at hand, the churning among the batch is intense. Everywhere and anywhere, all you see people doing is discussing the case.
A small batch size takes away the luxury from a student to hide behind a mass of students. If a student does not put up requisite amount of hard work, it shows up and the student has to pay for it. And this takes competition to an extreme level.
And it is this competitive spirit that becomes nothing less than a way of living at DMS. We, in this session alone, have made it to the finals of 157 competitions. And these competitions are ones where the best of the B schools across the country and even outside compete very, very fiercely for the top spot.
A major reason for the success of students of DMS in competition is the ingrained club culture among the students.
Okay, so I believe we've all gone through the Gold Rush case brief. Let me boil down the fundamental constructors, right? It's a low price point energy drink. The problem is very straightforward. Do I create a new category, market it as an energy drink, or do I get into the standard fizz competition arena?
Yes. Yeah, what I feel is that they should aggressively market themselves as an energy drink because it's a brand new category and there exists a market gap there. So they should look to dominate that firm and create a monopoly out there.
Rahul.
Yeah. Well, rather than going for an energy drink, they should go as a carbonated drink, because in the Indian economy will find it difficult to digest the concept of energy drink. Right now, the big players, the monopoly players, which are the premium brands, they are targeting at a higher segment and we are at the low price point. So we should go as an alternative for carbonated drinks.
So first of all, I think you have to introduce energy drink as a prominent drink in that particular startup first, and then try to go and, you know, put your product into that market. Then only I think you will succeed.
Now, to solve such cases, I believe we should start looking at concepts like, you know, very fundamental questions. Why do I purchase any kind of drink? Right? You know, one is the standard thirst perspective. You know, I'm thirsty. Pyaas bujhti hai. The other part of it is, obviously, it has a certain status symbol associated with a certain idea that, you know, this defines me.
And all these discussions are structured and they become a part of our monthly e-magazine, Rayansh.
And then there's the fun part, events and seminars at DMS IITM.
We have excelled in research. The number of research publications are the largest for the department.
Professors at DMS continuously organize international level conferences that are attended by all sorts of managers around the world. And when, to the surprise of many, all this is organized by our very own students. Events such as BII, Confluence, Marketing and Finance Weekends, seminars, and many others give students a very unique chance of learning all that they can.
Another unique offering of DMS is a one-month mandatory winter internship. Students are sent on a one-month winter internship where they are expected to apply their knowledge in corporation across various domains.
A unique concept of DMS is a 4-week-long winter internship that a student undertakes in the month of December. This, in addition to the summer internship, allows the student to have corporate exposure and gives him much-needed early mover advantage.
When I was joining this profession, I was asked in my interview, wouldn't you get bored teaching the same course over and over again? Well, now that I'm 25 years down into this profession, I can say very clearly, we never really repeat a course. Every time we deliver a course, it significantly changes. It modifies, it grows, it's organic in nature.
We have been the pioneer in the country. We started IPR education in 1992. The teaching and research are in the fabric of the culture of IIT Delhi. And we just take it forward.